Wow, I have got an awesome, awesome Funko Pop Grail all the way from...
America.
New Zealand.
New Zealand.
Right, so this is a fantastic Funko Pop vinyl. It's a Grail, has to be said. This is one that I've wanted for quite some time. Now, I had to look...
Somebody needs to count how many times
everywhere.
Grail.
Everywhere. Grails are ones that you can't easily get hold of, ones that you've wanted for quite some time.
How long have you wanted it for?
Ages, actually, since we first started watching the...
3 weeks?
No, since we started watching the Vikings, I would like to have got... Oh, you know what it is now?
Yes.
I would like to get, if I can, all of the Vikings figures, although they're all very expensive, so I may just keep to this particular one. Now...
You're just going to get one.
There's a reason. There is a reason.
I know there's a reason. But you can't just get one.
My favourite character.
But why is it your favourite character?
Katheryn Winnick.
I know why it's your favourite character.
Lagertha. Lagertha from the Vikings. I had to look everywhere for this Funko Pop, all over the world, yeah? Reason being is next Friday, myself... Jason from Not Suitable for Mum, the Pop-Tart Lee, and Tell from Tell Talks are going up to Liverpool Comic Con. And I have already pre-booked...
It's going to be lovely, yeah.
I have already pre-booked an autograph session and to meet Katheryn Winnick, who plays Lagertha.
He's already booked the
bedroom. So, anyway... I've already said on this channel that I'm already meeting Giancarlo Esposito. I'm also, and that's pre-booked, but that's Gus Fring, Moff Gideon from Star Wars, Gus Fring from Breaking Bad. I'm also pre-booked Katheryn Winnick. So I will be guaranteed to meet her. And I wanted to get the Lagertha Funko Pop. Now, those that collect Funkos will know, or possibly those that are into the Vikings, will know that this is a very rare... an expensive Funko Pop vinyl, and I could not find it anywhere. Pop Figures in the UK had it very, very briefly, but it sold out too quickly before I was actually going to get it, and that was quite a lot of money. Okay. This one, I went to Pop Guardian, New Zealand, and check their website out, because it's fantastic. They are apparently the premium Funko Pop sellers from New Zealand. Strange place to get a pop figure from, I hear you ask.
That's what I thought.
That's what you... Did you? And I thought the same. But their website is fantastic, and I will put links in the description below. But I got chatting to the guy that owns it, and I said, look, nowhere can I see on your website that you ship to England. And I really... You've got this Funko I have to have, because I'm getting it signed, blah, blah, blah. And
how could you get it signed if you hadn't got it?
Well, I had to get it before I went away for the con. And now I've got it, a week before. So it's come from New Zealand. He quoted me. He had to go down to the post office because he had no idea how much it was going to cost. I also asked a friend of mine that lives in New Zealand, and she was quoting about £100 to send it over. I mean, the prices... Ooh, I don't know why it's so expensive to ship from New Zealand. This guy quoted me £60.
£60 just for packing and posting?
Yeah, but New Zealand is like, it's a long way away, you know? It's not just...
Have you seriously paid £60 just for postage?
No. It was £4.99. What? Yeah, £60. Pop itself was $135, I think. I'll put all the description up. Don't look at me. I'll put it all... on screen. Do you want to open it?
No, I don't.
Apologies for the break in our programme. We're doing our best to get it back to you as soon as we can.
£200 for...
No, it wasn't £200. It was about 100 and something. Yeah.
130 plus 60.
$135.
It's about the same.
New Zealand dollars. A bit dodgy.
Oh.
I've got it, and it does look in fantastic condition. What? I'm getting this signed by Katheryn Winnick.
I couldn't give any shits less more.
I told you I bought it. You know it was an expensive one.
Not for this price, I didn't.
Oh, well, I did get it.
Oh, I can see that, though.
Right, let me stop. All right. So carry on.
Well, you better hurry up.
Right. So yeah, I mean, I'm going to get it signed as well. So this is going to be an awesome Funko Pop to have signed. It's actually my most expensive, or will be my most expensive signed and only signed Grail, really. I've got quite a lot of Pop signed now, but none of them of Grail standard.
Don't
do that. It's starting to cold us out. Here we go. Here's the packaging. So, like I said, go check out Pop Guardian. I'll give it 10 out of 10 for customer service, because I literally went to this fella and said, look, there's my situation. I'm going to a con. You've got a Pop that I desperately need. I can't get it anywhere else in the world. I looked all over Europe, England, America. Couldn't find it. Found one. I found a few on eBay. Be very, very careful of that. Because there are fakes on eBay, as everyone knows, but there's absolute clear fakes on eBay.
Could we go a little bit quicker with this?
I'm trying to.
You are going to have to actually stop. Sorry.
Why are we going?
Because I'm
desperate
for a poo.
Abby!
I'm sorry. You're cutting all that out, aren't you?
Yeah. So, as I was... So all in, I've spent about £150, I think, roughly, to get this delivered and received. It's about the going rate, I think, for a Grail of this sort. But it looked in great condition, and the guy from the company I contacted.
You've
him.
Lost your train.
Yeah, I have. So the guy from the company, I was contacting him quite a few times actually, and it was all really weird because he was in the middle of the night and I was in the daytime, and it was all a bit, you know, it was about a day delay in getting the responses, which made sense as he was in New Zealand. But we got there in the end, and he said, "I've got this quote, £60 to post it to you. I'll get it to you before the con," and it was really, really helpful. So guys, check out his website. I mean, if you want something in particular that you can't get hold of, I mean, whether or not he'll do this for anyone else, I don't know. But I will send him this video and express my absolute gratitude for getting this to me before the con
for
at Liverpool next week. Don't listen to Abby. I'm well appreciative of what you've done.
He is very, very appreciative.
Right. Let's see what has come here then. So we've got some Under Armour bags. Bit weird.
I like Under Armour. I don't really want their bags, but.
So this is all the packaging. That's all coming out here. Look, going everywhere. Loads of it.
Yeah, that's quite.
Here's the Funko in bubble wrap. A little more of the Under Armour bags. So let's get rid of those. Sort that out later. So here's the Pop itself. Oh, I can feel it's in a Pop protector as well. And it's in bubble wrap. So wrapping was, again, a 10 out of 10. This looks to have arrived perfectly from New Zealand. It's taken...
How old is this Pop?
I'm not entirely sure. I know it's quite a number of years old. But it's taken about... It took about 10 days to arrive from New Zealand. It's put in a hard stack. This is excellent. And it's the hard stack that I will take as well, because I don't want this getting damaged in my my box.
It does look like.
In my bag, sorry. There's a bit there. Let's have a look. Let's get it out. I'll have a look.
But for a fairly old Pop.
God, I can't get it out. Cool. That's in there tight. Wow. I can't get it out. Cool, that's almost too tight. Yeah, that's not brilliant, that. I mean, that's minor.
Yeah. I think even just by doing that...
Very minor crease on the back.
I think that possibly has been done putting it in there.
It's very good condition. Some of the ones I did see were not in anywhere near as good condition as this. So this is Lagertha number 178, the Funko Pop Pop Television vinyl.
I don't know why you wouldn't want to get the rest of those, because they all look very good.
And they are cool, yeah.
That Floki one's good.
They're on the back there. Ragnar is another great character. Floki, like you said. Rollo. King Rollo is allegedly my 27th great-grandfather. This is fact.
Lee, that's Polo.
Who the fuck's Polo? Rollo is my 27th great-grandfather. We go back generations. And, so that's cool. He actually goes to a lot of cons as well, so I might end up getting Rollo one day. I think box-wise, yes, I'm happy with that. There's the odd scrape and the tiny little knock and creases. I don't know if you can see. Yeah, look, there you go. That little bit in the corner there. They've never made any more, though. They only made these five, as far as I'm aware. That I didn't like, so I'm going to have a look at that. I'm going to put that in a different case. That was way too squashy for some reason. Nothing wrong with squashy. Let's get her out. Let's get her out and have a look. And I'm going to do this very, very carefully. Obviously, this is a very expensive Funko Pop. But I think all things considered, and the age of the Funko, that's in very, very good condition. And I can't wait to get this signed by Lagertha, Katheryn Winnick herself. I might even tell her the trouble that I went to.
She's going to be absolutely thrilled with that story.
You think?
Yeah. I think you should tell her, Lee.
I might. I've been thinking about
it. She's going to want to know.
Yeah, I've been thinking that it's something that she should probably know about. There we go.
That is a very nice pop.
That's weird, because it was already on the stand.
That you can see the age of the... I don't know if you can see it, but that's all quite discoloured. But I think that's just the... excuse the sniff.
Oh, that's cool, actually.
I don't know if I can detect smoke on that.
Well, it's just...
possibly very, very faint.
No, I can't. No, that's not discoloured, Abby. That's that yellow light that I've got shining down on it.
Fuck me. Yeah, why would you have a yellow light on it?
Because I have yellow for spotlight.
Perfect. Forget that.
And these LEDs for... look.
Seriously? Why? Yeah, it's perfect. I can see up there. Why would you have a yellow light?
Because I have that for spotlighting.
Yeah, but it's shit, because it makes everything look dirty then, doesn't it?
No, it doesn't, Abby. It's very, very...
But it does. I've just looked at it and thought, oh, that's a bit dirty. Oh, yes, I can smell smoke on that. Obviously, I fucking can't. Then get up.
There we go.
If it looks slightly yellow, just ignore it. It's not. You shouldn't have that on there.
Okay, I'll learn from you. Lighting.
It's because he's colourblind.
I am colourblind, actually.
Oh, nice. Well, I just said it.
There you go.
That is very nice. It looks like she has a wolf cut for her hair, doesn't it?
Wolf bangs, yep.
Very nice.
For those that don't know, I am a trained dresser of hair. And I did some wolf bangs for the first time the other day, didn't I? That isn't my main occupation, by the way. That's just a hobby.
Fucking weird.
There you go. That's Lagertha. Look at that.
I do like it, actually. Yeah.
I'm pretty pleased to have got that. Especially one that I'm now going to go and get signed as well. So very soon, Lagertha, Katheryn Winnick will have written on the front there. And it is in very, very good condition. Yep. Happy with that. That's absolutely fine, isn't it?
Yeah.
Brilliant.
She's going to write "you twat" written on the front.
How much?
I'm with her.
Yeah, there you go. If you haven't seen Vikings, go and watch it. Brilliant show. That's it. Let me know what you thought of that below. Check me out over the next couple of weeks. I'll be vlogging from the con itself. And if you are going to the con, come and say... And if you are going to the con, come and say hello. Because
I was wondering what you're going to say then.
Yeah, I didn't know.
Come say hello.
Don't. I'm not interested.
Fuck off.
Just leave me the fuck alone. If you are coming to the con, come say hello, and hopefully we'll catch some of you there. Till next time, TTFN. I won't just survive. Oh, you will see me thrive. Can write my story. I'm beyond.
Unchained.